Hi everyone, good evening. My name is Unnimaya. I'm a PhD student in materials chemistry at Stockholms universitet. And my PhD project focuses on lignin-based materials for advanced separation processes. I would like to go back in time when I started my PhD, exactly when I didn't know anything about lignin. You might have probably heard the story of blind people trying to figure out how an elephant looked like by touching different parts of it, right? I was one among these people who was trying to figure out what all lignin can do and what all potential it has. Now, think of lignin like a blind man describing an elephant. It has a bit of everything, right? Tunable functionality, antimicrobial, UV blocking, check. But there is a catch. Unlocking lignin's potential is not simple. Like any treasure, it takes effort and strategy to uncover its true value. Making lignin suitable for separation application is not a one-size-fits-all process. It takes deliberate modification. And through experimentation, I have unlocked lignin's potential to address some of our pressing environmental issues. For instance, did you know that the fashion industry is one of the largest polluters of water worldwide? Every year, 200,000 tons of dyes are dumped into our rivers, turning them into toxic streams. Our first aim was to adsorb these dyes using lignin-based microfibers. You might be wondering, what is it so much interesting about lignin-based microfibers? Well, for me, it was truly fascinating because of the way they are made. They are made by melting modified lignin and spinning them. Still not convinced it's exciting, right? Let me explain why it is. Who doesn't like cotton candy? They were made using cotton candy machine the same way as the sugar candies are made. It was watching science meeting fun in the most unexpected way. The process is not only creative, but also scalable and sustainable. And here, it gets even cooler. I made these fibers magnetic. How? By incorporating magnetite nanoparticles directly to lignin without any chemical reaction. In this way, we can easily remove adsorbents from water just using a magnet, without the need for any complex filtration system. Dyes are not just a problem. Oil in water is also a huge problem, and these fibers can help us again. They act like filter paper, easily soaking up oil from water since they are hydrophobic. Perfect for tackling oil spills. And that's not the end. They can also pull heavy metals from water with a unique ability to adsorb toxins. So, they are a perfect solution to many of our toughest environmental problems. From oil spills to heavy metal contamination, making our water cleaner and safer. Now, let's dive into a smaller scale. Nanofibers from lignin. From cotton candy machine, I'm switching to electrospinning, a technique that lets us create fibers in the nanometer scale. These fibers are then explored for separation application. Usually, nanofibers are carbonized to make them ideal for carbon capture application because of their high surface area, porosity, layered structure, etc., as you see here. But beyond that, what if we could use them as such as separation membranes? But still, structural integrity could be a problem. To tackle this, here comes our third component, lignin nanoparticle, formed by solvent shifting method, or simply switching solvents. With a high surface area, we can easily functionalize them, making them suitable for a wide range of application. Among which, I chose nature's own enzymes for functionalization. Combining lignin nanoparticles and lignin nanofibers opens a door for advanced separation membranes. Lignin nanoparticles are functionalized with enzymes, where lignin nanofibers stabilize them by preventing enzyme leaching. Now, you may ask, why enzymes? The major problem with separation membrane is biofouling. It happens when biofilms form on the membrane surface. Enzymes are nature's cleaners, and they can specifically target and degrade proteins, which is a key building block of biofilms. without harming the membrane. Since we were talking about separation, is it just for water purification? No, and it doesn't stop there either. It goes beyond water. And lignin is one of the most sustainable material that we have. We can completely explore new application that goes beyond the ordinary. Let's have a closer look. What else can we separate? How about light? Natural photonic material manipulate light through their structure. These materials create stunning colors like shimmer of a butterfly wing by reflecting light through nano or microscale structures. Lignin can also be used to separate light, transforming its usual brown color into rainbow colors. Lignin nanoparticle can self-assemble into tiny structures, creating stunning biodegradable colors, just like a peacock feather. Would you now say lignin is a waste? It isn't just plant's armor. It is a powerhouse for sustainable innovation, and the future of the clean technology could be completely rooted into this humble plant polymer, proving nature holds the key to solving some of our biggest challenges. With that, I would like to conclude, and I would like to thank SPC and Gunnar Sundblad Foundation for the opportunity to talk today, Stockholm University, Swedish Research Council, and my supervisor, Mika Siponen, for their immense support. And I would also like to thank Carl, Bjorn, and co-participants, as well as Billerud, for the support. This is Unnimaya. Thank you for listening.